do have now along to accompany this 5 p.m. forecast. We have the National Weather Service be ready to begin their explanation. Let's go to the National Weather Service now.
Through this evening and Kauai overnight. So we really want to maintain the message to urge residents to remain vigilant and not let their guard down. Hurricane Douglas remains a Category 1 hurricane with sustained winds of 85 miles per hour. Douglas continues to move in a west-northwest motion at about 16 miles per hour. Currently, Douglas is about 90 miles northwest of Kahului and about 60 miles northeast of Honolulu. For this latest forecast package, the hurricane warning for the islands of Maui, Lanai, Molokai, and Kaho'olawe in Maui County have been canceled. A hurricane warning remains in effect for Oahu, Kauai, and Ni'ihau. Here are the winds we're expecting. We are expecting hurricane conditions across portions of Oahu this evening and on Kauai tonight. Due to the steep terrain of the islands, some of these localized winds interacting with the terrain can cause stronger wind gusts, and that can be expected tonight. As for surf, we've been seeing some large swells already generated by Douglas, which is affecting some of the eastern shores and north-facing shores of the Hawaiian Islands. Some of these surf can be life-threatening if people are out there. Potentially damaging surf along these exposed shores can be very dangerous. But we're also still anticipating up to a 2-foot storm surge on top of these damaging surf. So you know, that makes it a particularly dangerous situation. We've already had reports of road closures along Kamehameha Highway near Ka'ava due to debris on the road. As for rainfall, we still continue to expect a potentially heavy rainfall with Douglas to affect any portions of the Hawaiian Islands tonight and into Monday. Some of the rain accumulations can be upwards of 3 to 6 inches, and some of these could be higher in some of the localized areas near mountains and elevated terrain. Some of this rainfall can create life-threatening flash flooding and landslides, as well as rapid water rises in small streams. So anyone in low-lying areas, flood-prone areas, should still remain vigilant through Monday. That is pretty much all I had to report for the 5 p.m. Update. So we will turn it over to Ash Evans. He is my colleague who will be taking down any questions, if there are any. Ash, do we have any?
Yes, Erik, yes, we do. First question, what time will be the height of the storm for Honolulu? I think you already touched on that earlier, but go back and recap if you can.
Yeah, going back to Honolulu, the system right now is about 60 miles northeast of Honolulu. So anytime through the next few hours into this evening, as Douglas moves northwest, west-northwest, and any portions of Honolulu on Oahu could see some impacts from potentially strong winds, tropical storm force to even hurricane force winds, particularly on the north side of the island, north and northeast side. And as that system moves west, we could start to see the wind shift out to southerly winds as Douglas moves further northwest. So we can expect these squirrely winds to affect the island through about midnight tonight.
Next question, Erik, is there still a possibility that Hurricane Douglas will directly hit Oahu? And then second portion of that question, could it still directly hit Kauai? Over.
Sure. So, we can't rule out the possibility that it could make a jog to the left of the track to impact Oahu. And so that's why we still have the hurricane warning in effect for Oahu through tonight. So we want to urge everyone to remain vigilant. We want to make sure everybody, you know, keeps on watching the forecast and the conditions out there to make sure that they remain safe. As for Kauai, that's still not out of the question as well. We can, Kauai is a little bit farther north in latitude, but as Douglas continues its west-northwest track, you know, Kauai could still definitely feel some impacts, even if we do not get a direct hit from Douglas on Kauai. So, you know, some of the impacts still extend far out from the center. So we don't want people to really focus in on the center too much, but realize that there are impacts that stretch out and we could be affected by those.
Okay, Erik, next question. Can you describe the direction that Hurricane Douglas took as it approached Maui and Molokai, and what areas actually ended up being in the path of the storm?
Yeah, so, you know, it continued to take that west-northwest path as it approached Maui and into north of Oahu. We're going to continue to expect that to happen. Luckily, we've been on the southern side of the system, which really didn't bring, you know, the full potential impact that it could have, even though that it was still really close to the islands. We were really playing with a really fine line, a razor-thin line between what we've experienced today compared to what we could have experienced just a few 20 miles offshore with all the heavy convection and potentially damaging winds associated with Douglas.
I think you possibly touched on this earlier, but the next question is it possible that it may cross, that Hurricane Douglas may cross over part of Oahu?
Right, so yeah, we touched on that a little bit. Like I said earlier, it still remains a possibility that it could happen if Douglas takes a small jog to the left of the track. And that's why we continue to maintain that Oahu remains in that hurricane warning through tonight. We don't want people to let their guard down, and we want people to really prepare for the worst case scenario. And that also includes a potential leftward jog into Oahu.
And so there's an addition to that specific question. And if so, which parts of Oahu would be most affected?
Right, so that's all going to depend on how far south of the jog it takes, if it does. And you could start to see conditions deteriorating from the north shore to the windward side first, as that deep convection moves over that part of the area, if that were to happen. So those areas along Kahuku down to Kailua and into Kaneohe that on the windward side, we could start to see those conditions deteriorate first. And depending on how far south it takes the jog, if it does, we could also see some of those conditions move over the Ko'olau's and potentially into the central Oahu and maybe into the downtown area. So it's still not out of the realm of possibilities. So we want people to really remain vigilant and, you know, stay prepared at least through tonight.
So next question, Erik, is any indication that the Hurricane Douglas will deviate from its northwestern direction at this point?
You know, at this point, the Douglas has been fairly well behaved. We saw in the past few days some of the small jogs that it took, north and south. But for the most part, it's been fairly consistent on this trajectory towards the northwest. We don't have any reason right now to believe that it would deviate significantly from that track. But also as it encounters more wind shear, as it continues to move northwest, the system can continue to weaken, which would then kind of be controlled by more of the low-level flow. And that could possibly bring the system further to the west or further to the south if that were to happen. So there is that realm of possibility that it is there. As it weakens, we could still see some movement to the south.
Sorry, Erik, I lost my mute button for a second. You mentioned that there was a razor-thin line between the actual impacts and what we could have experienced. What factors impacted the storm over the last couple of days and prevented it becoming worse than it actually was and will be?
Typically in tropical cyclones, the southwest quadrant is usually not as bad as the northeast and the right side of the eye. We were fairly lucky that, the main Hawaiian islands were pretty much in that southwest quadrant. And that the system didn't take too much of a jog further south. So that razor thin line, we're talking almost 20 to 30 miles, that could have made a really big difference in what we could have seen over the last 24 to 48 hours, depending on that, that razor thin line. So I think we can really feel fortunate that it took the path that it did and that things were not as bad as it could have been.
Last question, Erik, that I have on the list here, and then I'll check the operations account quick. Can you restate your name and position title for the audience, please?
Sure. My name is Erik Lau, and I'm a meteorologist with the National Weather Service.